A very good afternoon to all of you. My name is Manish Vardhandek, and I'm going to be the host for today's webinar. My colleague from our head office in Noida, Abhay Kapkoti, is also going to be a co-host for today's webinar. So, on behalf of Manupatra, we would like to welcome you to this webinar for legal research on Manupatra for corporates. About Manupatra, the happy thing for us, which is very unlike this particular year, is that we are a 20-year-old company today, and it's we'd like to thank the entire legal fraternity who has helped us evolve as a company. So that's the happy thing for us for this particular year, that we are a 20-year-old company. Manupatra, it's a pan-India company, and it's a preferred research tool by the entire legal fraternity, including, of course, corporates, which tend to use within their legal departments and the secretarial and the taxation departments. So starting about today's webinar, the topic what we have for today is how can Manupatra play an important role for conducting the research within corporates. So basically what I'm going to do is in this particular webinar, is it's going to be material specific more towards corporate, which is going to be of prominent use to them. That is going to be showcased out over here. The broad topics, of course, what we'll be covering on this particular webinar are, of course, on the screen. It's going to be an overview of entire collection material on Manupatra, which is specific for corporate research. So I'll just take you through. Okay. Now, when it comes to corporates, like generally what you tend to require the most is access to their acts. Like that is something which is of core importance, the laws. So what I'm also going to present simultaneously is I've already logged in onto our database, manupatra.com, the portal which is very familiar to each and all. That's our home page. Now, to get access to the database, what you require is a sign-in and a password. Once you punch in this particular details, you come across this particular screen, which I've already logged in onto. So this is the home page of Manupatra. The left-hand side, the TOC is the table of contents. So what I'm going to browse you through today is starting with Bare Acts. Now, what we cover on Manupatra on the Bare Acts section is Central Acts as well as State Acts. The navigation is very easy. You just have to click on the plus signs to expand this particular section, and you click on Table of Contents, which opens a menu on the right-hand side, which offers you multiple options of actually accessing the menu in various ways. Either you can go for the alphabetical index of Bare Acts and you can browse through all the Bare Acts on an alphabetical listing, or you have got a ministry-wise, subject-wise, industry-wise segregation also available. So I'm just going to click on the alphabetical index and just try to show you how this menu appears. Now, every time I click on any particular alphabet, it's going to display all such acts, starting with that particular alphabet. All can display a list of all the acts with all the alphabets, of course. Well, let me just run you through what are the icons which appear on the Bare Acts. Like starting with E, I've got a host of acts which start with the alphabet A, E. Let me show you something which has the most number of icons. Okay. Now, the Employee Provident Fund and Miscellaneous Provisions Act 1952. If I click over here, it's going to open the act section by section, chapter by chapter, and you can browse through the entire length of the act. If at all I want to have the act in a single document, I want to take a neat print of it, I've got an option where I can, the last icon next to each of the act is View Act in a Single Document. So once I click over here, it's going to open the act in a single document, which I can, of course, do it this way. But then what I can also do is, okay, now There are quite a lot many icons out over here. I'll just give you the importance of each and all. Now, okay, this is the Essential Commodities Act. Now, this particular icon indicates we have this particular act also available in vernacular languages also. So if I click on Hindi, Gujarati or Marathi, we get to see the copy of the act in that particular language. So it's the same act which is also available. We do, as I mentioned, Manupatra is a company which is pan India. We've got clientele spread across various sectors. There are at times places where people, of course, see it as a challenge to read everything in English. So for easy English interpretation, like we've got and this acts into various languages. This particular icon will give you the brief facts and the statement of objective about the act. So what we see is Essential Commodities Commodities Act, the statement of objective for this particular thing. This is a direct link to the rules and regulations available for the Bare Acts. Of course, apart from that, we do have a link for rules and regulations out of here also. The last icon is annotations, brief notes on sections. So when I open this, what we get is brief notes on each of the section and annotations out of here. You can of course email this, you can print this, everything is something which gives you that liberty to email and print. The most important thing is this particular icon, the Parliament icon on this particular act. This indicates to me that there's a pending bill, there's an amendment proposed in this particular act. And if I want to actually track that amendment, what I can do is when I click on the act itself, it gives me a link to see what is the pending bill. So if I click over here, I can get to see the text of the pending bill also from here. Thus, of course, like we've arranged all these pending bills, there's a different module altogether which lists out all pending bills in the parliament. We'll of course go through that at a later stage. So this opens the hyperlink, opens the pending bill. This is the proposed section on which the amendment is proposed. Now, as I did mention, we click the act from the page itself. It opens section by section, chapter by chapter. You click on any particular section, it's going to open that particular chapter and section. What we also see is the blue icons on the extreme right are all such judgments corresponding to this particular sections. So this is something, if I click on any particular section, I click on the blue icon, it's going to open all corresponding judgments relevant to that particular section. So that's a list of all of them. Of course, like searching for case laws and like browsing through it and sorting and filtering, we are of course going to cover in detail in this particular session. Now, apart from Bare Acts, that's of course, like we saw on the menu, it can be also segregated industry wise. So if I want to see any particular acts for a particular industry like banks or FMCG, that's also segregated out of here. For reference, what we've also done is all such acts which are repealed, we do have a compilation of all of them also that can be seen over there. The acts which you open from the alphabetical index or the chronological index are all updated with all the latest latest amendments incorporated into that. But then at times, if I only want to see such acts for various years which only had amendments, that I can see from this particular menu. So that of course becomes possible. Like I did mention, apart from Bare Acts, we do have rules and regulations. So that's the link for, so you just click on rules or regulation or orders and you get to see all the regulations for that. Now there's also one more important thing on Bare Acts, which I'll rather again revert back and try to show it to you. Like there's a very important kind of a new feature what we have actually put in place on the Bare Acts is if I am having a look at something like the Companies Act, for example. Now the Companies Act 2013, the new regime, Because if I want to make a comparison of that particular act with the older act, the Companies Act 1956, what I have got is a comparative chart which actually places both the acts besides each other. And what we can actually do is compare the provisions for each of the act. And there can be certain provisions which are omitted there. There can be certain provisions which have been added in either of the acts. So we can have a snapshot of both the acts in one go, and we can see both of them. So this kind of comparative charts are very much available on various acts. Like there are certain acts, like in relation to electricity, like they are something like four acts on which we'll have provisions of different years. Like if I just maybe. Like I was mentioning, the Electricity Act. Now, what we see, the Electricity Act of 2003, the Electricity Regulatory Commission Act of 1998, the Electric Supply Act of 1948 and 1910. And what we see is all the provisions of this are listed out of here, and it gives you a systematic comparative chart to have a look at this. The comparative chart is, of course, gives a comparative insight between the provisions of the law on a particular subject being in force at the present date and the old provisions of law on that particular subject. So this is something which we have included of late, and the industry has in particular taken a very good liking for this particular addition onto the bare act section. Browsing you through the pending bills, like I mentioned, of course acts are there, but then it all starts from here. Like the bills which are proposed, which further are enacted as acts. So what we have out of here is a compilation of all such pending bills which were proposed in the parliament. Now again, it's alphabetical, subject-wise or a chronological listing. I'll just browse you through the latest 2021. Now it gives a systematic kind of a menu again, the title of the bill. Again, you see the H icon is going to indicate that we have Hindi translations of this particular bill also. It gives the bill number and the year, the objective and the purpose, the house and date of introduction, the status, the assent date, and the date as such on which the act is enforced. Now, this is already an act now. So is the second one, so is the third. We do have a lot many. Okay, now the sixth one. Now this is yet to be enforced as act. This has still not got the assent from the president. This is something which is withdrawn. This stands withdrawn. And so on. So there can be certain thing, like this particular thing is still not passed by the Lok Sabha. So what you can actually see is the entire text of the pending bill also from this particular section. So browsing, it's, as I did mention, pretty easy. You just have to click on the plus signs out of here. Like if I want to see ordinances similar to very much to pending bills, I just click on a particular year. Again, it gives me the ordinance number, and the bill, the act, and the date of introduction of the ordinance. Again, you have got the text of all of them out of here. Now, a very important section on the menu, which comes very handy for the corporates, is notifications and circulars, which we cover from the central ministries as well as the state ministries. Clicking on the plus sign gives me, it opens the notifications into four routes where I can see we've segregated it for navigational ease. Anything which has come 2020 onwards is right on the top, and likewise, you've got all such notifications which have come up to the year 2003, which are in the last route. Now, it's just like clicking on the plus sign and actually browsing through a ministry. Like we're starting from Atomic Energy to Ministry of Finance, we've got all of them. You click on again a ministry, and what you get to see is all the various departments from which we have the notifications. Now, if I, for example, if I want to see a CBDT notification coming from Ministry of Finance 2020, now that's how the menu opens again. What we've also done is, it also gives you the notification number as well as a description about that. What we see is generally when you want to search for a case law, there can be various prepositions of laws. There can be a title on which you can search. It's very hard to remember a GSR. So what we've also done onto all such notifications is any kind of references within the notification. It can be anything from the past. They are all hyperlinked. So if I have to see something which is referred, I just have to click over here and it's going to open the notification copy here itself. Now, apart from the notifications, what we are covering over here and it being extensively hyperlinked, what we also see is, this is the new addition what we have done. We also give you the gazette copy. So that's the actual gazette copy of the notification. This can be downloaded, this can be printed. And if you actually go through the menu, you'll notice like any particular notification, we've added the gazette copy. So this comes in pretty handy. Generally, you'll see the Hindi, which is followed by the English gazette copy. So we do have gazette copies for all this notification and circulars. Ministry of Finance, of course, covered. Ministry of Corporate Affairs is something which again comes very handy when it comes to corporates. Again, we have our coverage from there also. So it's just browsing through the menu and you've got notifications of such kind. Addition to this, what we also cover is all such notifications and regulations and guidelines which come from SEBI. So again, I click on the plus sign, it shows me all the departments within SEBI from which the notification and the relevant circulars come in. So we do cover SEBI, we do cover the Reserve Bank of India. So we've got all the series for RBI, again, from where you've got various notifications and circulars. So this is something which is very easy to use. It's just browsing and actually navigating through it and actually picking up a notification which can be important. Of course, being a searchable database, you can use one of our search tools. At times, if you have a keyword, you can also select a particular ministry. If I want something out of only Ministry of Chemical and Fertilizers, I can simply give a keyword and do a search for that also. But then the browsing also, we've made navigation very easy with actually compiling it in such a way where browsing becomes very easy. Now, what we have also done, how Manupatra differs from quite a lot many other databases when it comes to catering to the corporate segment, is this isn't only a hardcore kind of a database only giving you case laws and only ads. But then what we have also done is, on this section of business and policy, what we have actually done is, like I did mention, we've got a corporate clientele pan India, and which is of course a very diversified kind of a way. So what we have is, on various subjects of law, we put down a sectoral view, like practically every corporate, like if they are a listed company, for them, this module of capital market is going to be very prominent, very important, because it's going to list out all such acts which are from the SEBI and touching the domain of capital markets. So like you have access to all the acts. Of course, you do have access to all the acts from the WARE Act section also. But then what this is doing is, this is only segregating all such acts only pertaining to the domain of capital market. So what we see is acts. Apart from that, what we see is rules and the regulations and the guidelines. So if I click on something like regulations, what we have is all such regulations which come from SEBI and which are updated on a very timely basis, where people find it very attractive to actually view everything at a snapshot. You get, apart from the legal content, we've got various notifications, various regulations also. Guidelines from in relation to capital market and SEBI, various schemes, various bills and ordinances. You also get to see various notifications and circulars pertaining to the domain of capital market. And all such information which can be relevant in respect to capital markets. So this is something which can be easily browsed and you can access the data from here. A very important module again can be like there are a lot many companies, of course, who may find IPR to be a very important subject. So what we also have out of here is an in-depth module on IPR. So everything touching intellectual property rights. So if I want to start my research with copyrights, so I get to see all kind of acts pertaining to copyrights, again all the rules. This is going to have the Indian perspective as well as a lot of international perspective also as a reference material. So if I want to see any conventions and treaties in relation to copyright violation, copyright law, so I can actually see that from here. If I want to see all acts, I can see that from here, or any kind of notifications, I can browse through that. If at all I want anything in relation to patents or trademarks, again, this is going to be everything actually structured in a very systematic manner. So I get to see all the acts and the bills in relation to IPR specific to patents from here, and all the other relevant information also. So broadly, what we see on IPR is, of course, everything in relation to copyrights and patents and trademarks. You've got state rules. You've got international agreements, conventions, and treaties. So that becomes a very important kind of a collection again. So you can actually see the patent cooperation treaties. You can see IPR protection treaties from here. And these are the full texts of all of them. So that's IPR. It gives you annual reports pertaining to the subject again. So similarly, each of this module is going to give you everything, the Indian perspective as well as the international perspective about that particular law and all relevant acts. And apart from that, of course, we do have case laws and all which we'll browse at a later stage. So this is that this particular module on consumer laws. So again, like capital market, this is going to cover in depth everything pertaining to that particular subject. As you see, like there are certain modules. We have got a clientele, as I did mention, we have evolved as a company. That is our customer base, corporates. So many things are very feedback based. Like there's a module based on minds and memories. Now, markets such as Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, we've got a lot many old companies subscribing with us. So anything specific to minds and memories, everything is bundled out over here. So you've got all kind of laws. It gives a nice sectoral view about that particular laws pertaining to that particular domain in this particular section of minds and memories. So is there a module on power and energy, which elaborates on all kind of laws in relation to that particular sector. Similarly, the names, of course, will indicate, like if I click on real estate, it's going to give me everything in relation to real estate. So all kind of laws bundled out together in relation to real estate out of here. Media and communication. So this are something, and this is something which, as I did mention, we've evolved. So any kind of feedback is most welcome. We can always come out with certain modules specific for a particular industry, which can come handy for research. So that's the business and policy section. And apart from that, we have a very important module in relation to taxation. But then before that, I'll rather take you to corporate laws, because from a secretarial department's point of view in a corporate, this becomes very important. So again, what you have got is all kind of central acts in relation to that. You've got various rules and regulations in relation to that. What we've also done is we've included quite a lot many compliance relating things in relation to this. So if you may find out something like due dates and penalties as per the new act. So it's going to give you a systematic checklist of what are certain dates on which certain things have to be complied as a company. So that material is very much out available over here. Apart from that, we do even have resolutions, which are formats, which comes pretty handy. Now, if I have to open one of them, I'll just. Okay. It comes this way. So this can be downloaded, this can be copied, this can be used for routine resolutions. It comes very handy. So that's something which is part of the corporate laws module, which is widely used by various corporates. Similarly, there are modules which can be very important for corporates, which are something like employment laws, which is subdivided into labor and industrial laws, and service laws, which again expands to give you a lot of information in relation to that market. The point we are trying to make is here we actually differ from quite a lot many databases, which is again, as I mentioned, only hardcore, only case laws. And it's a lot of supporting material, which can be, which comes handy, of course, which can be available here and there. But then our idea is to put everything under one roof. So navigation becomes very easy for a person who is in a critical need of doing research and having everything at his fingertips. So labor in the industrial, as I did mention, there's a voluminous module. There's a module on service laws again, which is also covered. And over and above that, the good thing is, of course, we do have certain things in relation to compliance. We have SEBI regulations and everything, and we have corporate laws compliance material. But then maybe start of the next year, we are planning to actually launch one of our new products, which is going to be a very specific and comprehensive product and a service on compliance. So that is something which we are, of course, looking forward to, and we'd like to showcase it to all of our corporate clients also. There's one particular thing I'll rather take time and show that to you, because what happens in corporates, we do have different departments. Like at times, what we also see is the taxation departments within corporates. What we generally see is the legal, the secretarial, the finance, the taxation. There are a lot of takeaways for all these departments. Now, even there's information specific to a taxation department where he's got everything pertaining to his area of research actually collated out over here. So what we see is, again, direct taxation relating laws. If he wants to see international taxation, it's part of it. If he wants to see a DTA, a double taxation avoidance agreement in between India and a different country, there's a exhaustive list of that. So this is something which comes very handy. You just have to click on the particular link and it's going to open the DTA treaty out of there. So a lot of information when it comes to model treaties and various treaty laws in respect to international, which is also part of this particular database. And similarly, what we have also got is a module on indirect taxation. In fact, we have got GST also out of here. We also have included GST rate finder, the important dates out of here in relation to GST. There's a rate finder. Now, either you have a, in case of goods, you have a HSN code, or in cases of service, you have a CC code. This can be easily, like you can actually, let me just show you. For example, if I want anything in relation to hotels, which offer a service. So I've got everything out of here. If at all, let me imagine a good for you, let's broadly say electronics. I'll just come back to this. I'll revert to this. Maybe a bad link at this point of time. Okay. So apart from the GST rate finders, so this gives you an overview about GST, all the rules, all the acts. So likewise, for all the other modules, this is going to give me everything pertaining to the subject when it comes to any kind of laws in relation to GST. So that's how our idea of showing you this business and policy module is a lot of information apart from the case laws and apart from the ads, which is part of Manapatra. There's one particular module also which is widely used in corporates is a draft agreement deed sample precedence. Comes very handy when you have something which is something you want to do in-house and not source it to any of your consultants or something. So what we've got is a host of sample agreements, sample deeds, relation to various topics. So if I click on any particular topic, like for example, if I click on company laws, it's going to show me a lot of agreements in relation to that particular topic. So that's the common equity subscriber agreement. Likewise, we've got a host of topics on which we've got sample agreements and deeds, which are part of here. I think I just figured out what exactly went wrong in case of the GST finder. And let me again show you the same thing. Okay. So I was not using the HSN code and I was putting electronics right over here. So it gives me the description for this too. Now, coming to the case laws, like Manupatra, of course, covers the case laws from the apex court right from inception 1950 onwards. And this is for each and every subject of law. That's for each and every subject of law. What you see over here is like the coverage starts from 1950. We do have Supreme Court orders also. And in addition to that, what we cover is various high courts. Now, again, this is either inception of the High Court, which actually in case of High Court it varies. Like there are certain courts like Bombay and Madras and Calcutta and Allahabad, which started way back. So we have their data starting from that particular date when the court started. So it's 1860 onwards for Bombay. So that's something which is very comprehensive. Addition to that, what we also have is all such courts which used to be India jurisdiction. So we have all the case laws compiled out over here. Like Lahore used to be India jurisdiction pre-1947. So we have all such judgments from Lahore. So was Rangoon and so was Sindh. Likewise, we also cover judgments from the Privy Council of India, which becomes very important even today. Of late, there can be quite a lot many judgments which are like cited from the Privy Council. So having a compilation of this always helps. So we have an exhaustive database of all such courts which used to be pre-1950, which are covered on this particular section. So what we have seen until now is their acts, how to practice the amendments, the judgments corresponding to various sections of the act, comparing two acts, looking for bills in the parliament and ordinances, accessing notification and circulars issued by central state governments, business policy, content collection specific to corporates, and the draft agreement deeds. Now, what we'll be seeing in this particular section now is the case laws. Like we have, as I did mention, we've got a host of courts and it's volumes and volumes of data. So to retrieve this information, we have some very interesting search tools, which I will be just demonstrating to you. Retrieve case laws, we've got, I'll start with legal search. Now, this is a search tool where you require, you can use any one of the parameters. We've offered you multiple parameters to conduct a search. It's a very easy search. Like at times, if I want to do a search based on a particular section of a particular bare act, I can do it from here. If I want to do a broad subjective search, like say, for example, if I want something like company law, and if I want to refine this by, let's say, amalgamation, so it becomes a very easy search for me and it displays me a list of judgments or results occurring for that particular query. What I can also do is, at times, if I have a party's name, I can simply just write down one of the party's name, or I can put in the second party's name. But then, even if I don't know it and I put only one of the party's name, and if I say a search, I can, of course, we can also do a refining of the search by selecting a particular domain or selecting a combination of domains for conducting that search. But then what we'll rather suggest and we prefer nowadays is to do a global search, because even at a later stage, it offers me a lot of options where I can actually filter and sort the results I've got. Like a very broad search, what I've done only for a corporate name is for Tata Motors, and what we see is something like 374 judgments for this. Now, as I did mention, if I want to at this stage only see judgments for Tata Motors from Supreme Court of India, the moment I click over here, it's going to only display me judgments for Tata Motors from that particular court. If I want to filter this, Tata Motors pronounced judgments, I want one of the quorums out over here. I want Anup Mohta from Bombay. So if I click over here, it's going to do it that way. I can reset it. Now, by default, all there are filters available where I can even select it period-wise. I can select a span of years, or I can select one specific year, and I can conduct that search. What I can also do is, if I want to search for judgments where the bench strength is it's a single bench judgment or a division bench or a four plus judgment, four plus judges case. I can do that by clicking over here, and it's only going to segregate it accordingly. On the right hand side, left hand side, we've got the filters. On the right hand side, we've got sorters. My relevance, every time you conduct your search, because I preferred my search to be conducted on relevance, it's going to be done on relevance. But then at times, if I want to see a judgment which has appeared latest, if I want to see a judgment of Tata Motors which has appeared only of late, I can do that. So I can see a judgment which is of 16th of September 2020, of course, oldest. This becomes important because with this particular sorter, I can only see, I can get to see all such judgments of Tata Motors which have been subsequently cited the maximum number of times in the court of law. Like this being a 2008 ruling, it has been later followed, referred, cited in more than 52 judgments. When I click over here, it's going to open all such judgments where this particular case has been subsequently cited. What I can also do on the result page is, if you notice, every time I move my cursor, this arrows appear. So what I can do with this is, once I click over here, we call this Manu instant. It gives me the party's name, in this particular judgment, what are the acts applied. It gives me the prior history, the case note, and the ratio. So reading this, if I think this judgment is important for me, and if I want to access it now, at that point of time, I can open that judgment from either from here, so it opens in the same window, or I can click it over here, so it opens in a different window. What we can also do is, many times we tend to do a search, and if I've got, let's say, 10 results on a page, and if I find the first judgment to be important, and I want to refer it at the end of my session, so we have this tool, we call it as add to session list, which the session is this particular login which I've done in now. So I've added this to my session list. I don't feel the second one is important. I feel the third one is important. I can add that also to my session list. And I say okay to that. My session list appears over here. At the end of my session where I've conducted research, I want to go back and have a look at those two judgments in detail. I can open them from here, or I can even email save print them using the actions out of here. So that is something which we tend to do on the session layers. And if I want to revert back to my results, I click over here. So it opens the results page right over here. Reverting back, I'll just show you one last thing on the legal search, because as I did mention, this has preset parameters, a very easy to use kind of a search. If I want to conduct a search on NI Act Section 138, for example, I can add in more sections also. So it opens a menu again. Again, it gives me all kind of options, where I can filter it, where I can sort it. Now, let me show you something where I can show you something which is where we have a SLP. Okay, so this is a particular judgment. Now you see this particular icon. What happens over here is, when I open this judgment,
I have this icon for SLP status. Now I can open this order. I'll of course come to this icons on the document page. So that's the SLP. Now this stamps this list. There's one particular thing I'll show you very fast. We do have a citation search also in place. So if I want something like, if I at times I don't have anything else, but except only for a citation. Like for example, if I've got a citation, EIR, and if it is for 2001, here I don't have volume. So if I have a page number one, and if I want to say like Supreme Court, so that's the judgment. So finding through legal search with parameters, finding through equivalent citations, that becomes a very easy task. The task many times what you may have is a complex query. So what we have done is like, let me just browse you through. Now, what I'm going to show you is ManuSearch, and we've got a case study out of here. Many times we read an article, we read a press release, and generally these things are very notorious for not actually giving the party's name. And what it exactly shows us is something about the judgment, and it always many a times tend to say in the recent development. So what I've done is I've already highlighted the text. So if I have to do a search on this particular topic, so this time I'm not using the legal search tool, I'm using ManuSearch. Now, the technology what we are using out of here is NLP, which is natural language process. If I directly even type this relevant topic, and if I search this, I can also take synonyms. And if I say, I can also only select Indian courts if I want Indian case laws in relation to this. Now, it says the latest judgment, so I will change my sorter to newest, but then even with relevance, it's given me specific to that topic. It's given me the most relevant judgment at the top, because if I see recent decision, developers were directed to pay compensation in excess of the contractually stipulated amount to flat purchasers. So if I open the text of this particular judgment, it exactly opens the most relevant judgment which the article talks about, which is from Supreme Court of India. The synonym thing helps, because this says buyer's agreement. What we had was a different word over there. So that's how the NLP actually works, and it helps you find the most relevant judgments. Features are plenty on the judgment page also, like this being a judgment which is 24/8/2020. This, like at this point of time, it's not been reported by any other journal, so it does not have equivalent citation. At any point of time, it's going to be reported. It's going to be. So I'll just browse you through this icons on a different window until I show you some other case studies also. Now, what we did on ManuSearch was we just saw how the NLP works. And okay, the second case study is, again, recently the Delhi High Court held that an order passed by a registrar of companies striking off the names of the company can be challenged. Now, it's just picking up the most crucial phrases and the words. What I'm going to do is, of course, this also can be easily found by NLP using, but then at times you may have certain queries which can be pretty complex, and you actually have to go a step-by-step way into searching for that particular database. So what this allows me is, if I do my search on territorial jurisdiction, and if I do a global search, registrar of companies, the only reason why I'm putting this within double inverted quotes is because I want it exactly as a phrase verbatim. So we've already conducted a search on territorial jurisdiction. Within that, now we are trying to see, we are defining it by putting in registrar of companies. And then again, using one more phrase which appears in the article and refining it further. So we get this case laws. Now it said Delhi High Court. So the first one is Kerala, I'll skip that, and that's the Delhi High Court judgment, which exactly works on that particular query which is posted on that particular article, and I get to see the most relevant judgment. So that's how you conduct a search for the most relevant judgment you want. Moving to one more case study of ours. Now this is something which we call as proximity search. This can be found on proximity. Now in this case, the Supreme Court has in its recent judgment settled the law relating to limitation for filing petitions for enforcement and execution of foreign awards. So what I'll do is, I'll just type this word to word in my Manu search tab. Now this time what I am doing is, I'm using this radio button. Now generally what we tend to do in a near each other thing is, we try to negate the very commonly used words like the ands and the fors. So what I am trying to look out for is limitation filing petition enforcement execution foreign awards. Now, I do know about this, it's not going to throw any results, but then only to demonstrate how the features work on this. Now, at times what may happen is, the article says awards, but then conducting a search, I'll always use my stemming feature, which says award, I put an asterisk. The judgment maybe can say executing a foreign award, so I again use my asterisk out of here. So it is the stemming tool. Now it can be petitions, it can be a single petition. So I use it over here. And this time I say a search. And what I get is the judgment, which I'm looking out for. So that's near each other. Now we were doing all this by this particular command. So we're using the radio button. But then we have a further search tool, assisted search, on which things are more simplified and a Boolean search can be conducted in a much more easier manner. I'll of course try to show you that also. So that's the judgment. Now let me just run you through the last of the case study. Okay. Now what this says is, we did have one of this question, how to search for the most relevant judgment, where there are numerous case laws under one particular provision of law. Now, generally, 304A of the IPC, generally not associated with corporates when conducting search. But then there can be an instance where 304A, which is exactly causing death due to negligence. There can be a case law here and there where there can be a corporation manufacturing something and there can be a malfunction which arises into certain things, and there's an implication liability on the corporate also. So doing that, so what we can actually do is, okay, that's the way how I'm going to do this. So assisted search. Now, this is Boolean search simplified. Now my keywords is negligence and death. I select a proximity of 5 words out of here. Now I know this word, all of these words, this has to be a part of my search. These words have to be in a proximity of 5 words. And when I say search, let me tell you, this is going to give me massive results, because generally negligence causing death in relation to 304A can be most of the judgments which are in relation to motor accidents and rash driving and many things. So if I want to negate something, if I want to negate a word, I've got this particular feature where none of these words. So it's going to filter out judgments where motor is not part of it. There can be, I can imagine one more word which can also be part where actually I should be negating that, which is medical. There can be medical negligence causing death here and there. So if I want to remove this, I do that. So this point of time I say search, and again what we get is nothing actually which is pertaining to company or something. So if I put in something like a company or maybe or something like a multinational company, so this gives me a particular judgment. Now I'll just open this. Now 304A, negligence caused due to death. This is Otis Elevator Company. So there can be, this can be relevant. So that's how you use the search mechanism. We can only guide you how to use the search mechanism, of course, law not being our cup of tea. So we can always guide you to the best way you can actually go about retrieving documents using the features onto the database. So that is something which is which can be easily done on proximity search. Exactly the phrase, you don't have to put the double inverted quotes over here. You just have to type in a query. If, for example, my query was infringement of copyright, I just type it. If I want something more along with it, I type it out over here. So that, of course, becomes possible. Let me just show you something very important, because at times what happens in law is, you're trying to search for something. Okay, there's a concrete railway judgment I searched for. Now there's a red flag out over here which indicates this particular judgment of 2002 has been overruled subsequently. So exactly what the flag indicates. So this particular judgment has been overruled. It does not stand as the good law today. To open the judgment which has overruled this particular judgment, I click on the red icon and it opens up out here. I think we would have positive time. I'll just maybe try to explain the features on the judgment page, which are aplenty. Like every time you see our citation, you click on that and it gives you all equivalent citations, where that particular judgment, apart from we being publishers, other publishers have also reported it, comes very handy, because at times when you're reading a piece of paper, you read something and you have nothing else but only a citation, the citation search is going to help you. What we see on this judgment is we can, of course, print this judgment in multiple formats. We can print and download it into PDF. That becomes very much possible. So that, of course, works in a very neat fashion where, like, the judgment is like displayed in a PDF copy. You can download it. That's the way the judgment template appears. Every page will have credits to the publisher as well as the user. So it becomes an authentic document, which is very much accepted in the court of law. When it comes to acceptance, what we are seeing of late in the court of law is in this environment of virtual court hearings is, again, there are quite a lot many databases which don't permit you a simple feature, something like even selecting a paragraph. So it's practically, we've heard about this, people are actually citing cases in this virtual hearings today nowadays, just selecting a particular thing. Apart from that, what we also have is a pretty good highlighter tool, which is the sticky note tool. Now, what you can do with this is you just go to the highlighter. Now, after that, you go to any such portion onto the site which you actually want to highlight. Now, that's highlighted. But then how this function actually comes handy is, if I want to put in a comment, I do a right click after that, I can write notes, and I can just like put in any kind of notes. I can name this particular thing, and I can save this. So this comes very handy where on this particular judgment, what I'll always have is this highlighted portion as well as my notes onto that. So within a department, within a team, when you share this document, it comes very handy. So that's sticky note. Now, if you see, everything on the site is like massively hyperlinked. So anything, if I want to see the judgment which was overruled, it gives me a ready hyperlink. That's the case note, the head note, the crux, the summary of the judgment, which is followed by the court copy. This comes pretty handy. There are important features. There's one more, what we call as important paragraph. Now, what we can do with this particular feature is, when I click over here, okay, in this particular judgment, there's a reference of this particular paragraph. The gray ones are other case laws. So when I click on this 38th paragraph is exactly verbatim used in this different in this other judgment of Supreme Court. So what we see is a recurrence of this particular paragraph in 5 such judgments of Supreme Court. So this becomes a tool if I want to identify the most important section of this judgment which has been cited again and again. So that comes in handy. So if I click on the second one, it's going to open again the same paragraph out of here. So that's M para. You can click on the third one. Now there's a different paragraph within the judgment which has occurred into 2 other judgments. It again, opening that again is in a similar fashion, where I have got this particular paragraph, and I open the, so the same paragraph again is mentioned word to word out of here. So that comes in pretty handy. So this particular feature is something which we call as MPARA. I'll just again revert back to my judgment. Every document on the site, be it a judgment, be it, you can mail it. That's using the mail function. You can, if there's any kind of lack of space, you can also save it to your cloud account or Google or a drop-down account of yours. This is one of our new display setting features, which actually like helps you in seeing the judgment as per your comfort level. If I prefer, which I am nowadays doing, if I want to see this into bigger alphabets, I can do that so. If I want to change the fonts, I can do that so. If I want to reset it, I can do that so. If I want the spacing to be increased, I can do that so. So that is something, reading a judgment, of course, on the screen, not although as enjoyable on the books, but then this makes it easier. That is this particular feature. So I just, so that's, coming back to, let me just open the same judgment to show you some more features on this. Now, what we also have is in litigation, many a times incorporates, at times you are into litigation, and of course, like in like you've got a consultant who's going to hire a counsel and he's going to appear in the court of law. But then if I want to see, actually this is an older judgment, but then I'd rather only to show you the utility of the feature, I'll use this one itself. So if I want to see analytics for Justice R.C. Lahoti, if my counsel has an appearance in front of him, when I click on the analytics button, what it displays is some very interesting facts about this. What it gives me is all his judgments for a particular year he's authored himself, or he's been part of bench for various years. More will display more number of years. What it also shows me is the various subjects he has appeared. This interestingly shows me the maximum appearances of a counsel in front of Justice R.C. Lahoti is Vishwanatha Iyer. So that, of course, shows me that particular list. Now, what it also shows me, interestingly, is like if I am a counsel, I have a appearance in front of Justice Lahoti. Justice Lahoti tends to like accept citations more, like the stats reveal that more of his judgments itself. So if I am a smart counsel, I'll try to search for a similar case where Justice R.C. Lahoti has presided over as the judge and try to present an old judgment of him, which is relevant to the new case I am standing for, and cite his case law. Like this, Justice J.C. Shah, again, he accepts quite a lot, many number of times. And these are judges who, like Justice Endler, like he's accepted maximum of such citations from Justice Lahoti. So if I have an appearance in front of him, it's not very conclusive, of course, but then research and has gone to this level where these are all features which we have incorporated based on the feedback from the end users. So this is something, in fact, we are going to come out with a very detailed counsel analysis also, where you can exactly get to see a counsel who's appeared for, let's say, for example, environment relating matters, and how, what is the disposition rate and all that kind of thing. So that is something which is again WIP, but then a very sought after feature by quite a lot many. This shows me the treatment of all such cases passed by Justice Lahoti, how many of them, how they have been treated subsequently. That's for Supreme Court, this is for High Courts. Now, we did see this on the results page, like this particular judgment subsequent to 2005, this has been, like we call this feature as cited in para. Now, what this does is, it exactly opens all such 875 references where this particular judgment in the background has been cited. Now, when I click on the plus sign, it's exactly going to open that particular paragraph where the judgment in the background has been cited. If I click on the citation, it's going to open the entire text of that. Going a step further, the authority check, what it's going to do is, it's a further extension to that particular feature where what I can see in a visualization kind of a feature is not only like this particular judgment, which we open in the background, has been every bubble you see on this graph is a reference. This judgment has been cited in the Supreme Court of India in this particular judgment. Now, if you notice on the screen, this judgment subsequently has been cited 171 number of times. While the same judgment has been cited over here, and this judgment has not yet been cited. So the size of the bubble indicates how many times the judgment has been subsequently cited. Corresponding to that, the size of the bubble differs. Now, if I have also got a segregator, if I only want to segregate all such judgments, where the judgment in the background SBP and Patel has been relied on. So what you see on the x-axis and y-axis is like I see Supreme Court of India. So this judgment has been cited over here. Gives me a very good indication if I like the point of law in this judgment. This is also going to be very important for my kind of research. So I open that judgment also and I see that also. Similarly, it shows me for high courts also. So that this particular feature, we call it as authority check. It gives me where that particular judgment has been cited. Extension to that particular feature again, what we have is a further feature, what we call as the case map. Now, what this is going to do is gives me the forward reference also, as well as the past reference also. So it's picking up 20 most strongest cases, and everything what you see on the left hand side is something prior to 2005, which has been cited over here. We have a legend out of here. So anything which is like this particular case law has been cited over here, and this has been discussed. This has been merely mentioned. Now somebody cited this particular case where this particular judgment of course has been overruled. And on the right hand side, what we see is this particular judgment has been cited over here and this has been affirmed. This case has been cited by somebody over here, but then the court feels this does not apply over here. So this has been dissented. So that's the case map on which I can actually pull up the most relevant judgments. Now, if I feel this has been discussed broadly over here, and when I click over here, this is going to open a further graph of this particular judgment. Now, this judgment where that particular case of SBP was referred, this has been subsequently relied on in this judgment. So I further go over here. So if I like this topic of law, I've started to build up a kind of a collection of judgments very similar to that nature. So that's the case map feature which appears out of here. I'll just revert back to my okay, we're done with the case study. Okay, being in corporates, of course, it's something like there's a lot of regulatory thing and all, and you need to be updated on a very timely basis. So for updates, what we have is various kind of things. I'll rather start with the second one first. That's the desktop alert. Now, I've got it installed out of here. So every time, okay, I believe on the share screen, okay, that's the desktop alert. So every time there's a legal update in the course of the day, this automatically pops up on the screen and it gives me a small synopsis about what the document is all about. The idea behind that being I am well aware of the latest updates. Now to install this particular thing, what we have is on our portal manupatra.com, we have this section which we call as on desktop. This can be easily downloaded for Windows as well as Mac from here, and you run the setup file. At times if there's a issue here and there with your firewall or something, you can of course refer that to your admin, your administrator, and he can well take care of that. So that is something which we call as the desktop alert, which comes very handy And like the only thing what we suggest is don't close this, just keep this minimized. So at any point of time, if there's a new update, this automatically pops up on the screen and I get what it is pertaining to. And if it is relevant to me, I go further and I actually read the document in detail. So that is what we call as list of alert. Then we have the e-newsline, which is every, on a weekly basis, we come out with the newsletter, which is widely appreciated across sectors. And if you have to register for that, what we strongly suggest is just put in your email ID and you can enter. So we register you, we subscribe you for the e-newsline, and you get it on a weekly basis. Basically, this gives you a snapshot of everything that happened in the past week. And it's a pretty informative document because it gives you access to all such judgments which comes from Supreme Court, High Court, various notifications which come from various domains, as well as news and press relating things. So that is something which comes pretty handy. Now, there's one more tool where you can be alerted once you log in onto the Manupatra page, and that is on my home page. I've got this section which we call as Manuclip. What we can actually do is, in fact, this is a selection of mine. So what we can do is, bear acts are, they get populated by itself. Any kind of amendments onto the bear acts, they do appear on this particular section by default. But then here on judgments, I can be selective. Like this is my selection, but then like at any point of time, if you want to change your selection again, you can do that. So anything which concerns your core area of relevance, core area of research, you can only select those particular subjects and you say submit to that. For notifications, similarly, you can only, you can either select all, of course, but then if you want to be selective and your core areas of research are only revolving under certain laws and certain ministries, so you can select any such which actually are as per your liking, again submit. So what happens then, I can select a duration. Like whatever appears over here is gonna appear for the next 3 days. So it gets on a rolling basis. So I can do that selection. And when I save this, the next time around, like everything gets auto collected out of here. So if I have any judgments in relation to the topics I have actually saved, they appear out of here. I've got a scroller, I can see more of them. All such notifications which I have collected, which I have selected, they are going to be collated out of here, and I can actually go through them. There's a hyperlink, of course, and you can open that. Case laws again, depending on the sections you have selected, subjects you have selected, they will get displayed accordingly. So that's about alerts and updates. And the last update is, of course, we have a WhatsApp alert also. For alerts, we'll request you to share your WhatsApp numbers on contact@manupatra.com, and we'll have you included for that particular thing. So that's basically what exactly what we wanted to display on this particular webinar and try to communicate that Manupatra, of course, differs largely than many other databases, where our offering is much more than only case laws. Of course, case laws are aplenty and exhaustive and comprehensive and can be searched on various parameters and the kind of technology what we have used. And there's a lot many things. WIP, as I did mention, the compliance relating product is going to hit starting of the next year, and we are very bullish about that. So that's about it. We'll most welcome. If I'm sure Abhay, being the co-host, is actually helping me a lot actually with the technology and answering a lot of things on the chat. But then anything apart from that, please, will be most welcome to welcome any kind of questions from you.
Right. So if anybody has any questions, they can write to us at chat. So I'm already answering whatever is coming there. Apart from that, also, if you want sir to answer something, then drop us a message.
Of course, apart from that, everybody who of you who has registered for this particular event, there's this feedback form which is going to come on your email. So we'll most appreciate if you can actually fill that up and let us know anything more about this particular thing and any kind of further webinars where you want us to cover any specific areas more in detail. Apart from that, you can always write to us on contact@manupatra.com for any kind of queries, feedback, subscription inquiries. So that's most welcome, of course.